This is Les from Wooden Ships Inner Journeys. Welcome back. This is the series for you to become the interpreter, the reader for yourself. So this is going to be the number 6, the Lover's card. So what you're going to do is you're going to look through, look at the cards and interpret them for what these cards mean to you at this time in your life. We're going to use 3 cards. We have the Dream Raven Tarot. We have the Rider-Waite Tarot, and we also have the Everyday Witch Tarot. And so basically, just follow the prompts. I hope you have some paper and pen so that you can write this down, because it is very insightful. I am totally enjoying this. I'm learning so much about myself at this time, and so I hope you are too. So let us get started. So today's card is the Lover, the Lover's card. Let me get this one right. So here the 3 are, the 3 different kinds of cards. So I think you should be able to see them pretty well. Okay, so first thing you need to do is, the first one is to find one element between the 3 cards that totally catches your attention first. So just one element, no matter how big or small, just look at each card. Stop this if you need to stop and take your time. You can pause this because there'll be a lot of pausing. So see which one it is, and whatever the element is, write it down, and then consider, okay, what does this element mean to me at this time? What is this? You know, what is it trying to say? You can also, too, after this is done, look it up on the internet. You know, find out what the meaning, what's the meaning of the moon? What's the meaning of a fire? And see how that plays into your life at this time. Okay, so stop this and the video and take care of that first question. Okay, this, you should be back now for the second question. The second question is basically the same thing as the first, but now find another element for each of these cards. So look at each card and see what element is calling you. Write each of those 3 items down. And then string those together in a couple sentences, a thought. See how those 3 weave together to offer you some really interesting guidance. Okay, stop the video and come back when you're done with that. Okay, you are back. Now the next thing we're going to do, I'm going to read to you from the Raven Dream Tarot, the information. And so I want you to think as I read this and see how this feels to you at this time in your life and what guidance is kind of calling to you. Okay, the Lovers. When the Lovers make an appearance, there is a level of commitment, contentment, and dreams that exist between 2 souls. Communication is paramount in their relationship. A unison of ideals and beliefs holds them together through the ups and downs. The focus of this card is communication. You have certainly been through the paces, but continue to keep the dream alive by keeping the communication lines open to work through any situation. Regardless of this indicates a romantic love interest, family, or even a working relationship. You are showing a level of commitment to ensure that it has a successful resolution. The reverse is the reverse suggests that communication has broken down, passions have waned into the sunset, and dreams have faded. If you are holding on to threads that are left behind you, you may want to ask why. This may also indicate a lover's feelings towards you are not as they seem. Time to step out of the world of dreams and face the issues at hand. All right, so contemplate that for a moment and then write what comes to you. Kind of like a little free-form writing, just whatever comes to mind, kind of write it down and just feel into these words. You can always pause this, stop it, and reverse it and listen to it again and get the guidance that comes from that. Okay. So if you want to do that now and come back. And then the last question is this. What do I truly love down deep? What do you truly love down deep? All right, another time of contemplation, little automatic writing. See what comes and see how it feels. All right, well, that's now it would be great to come back in a month. So, you know, work, do this work, learn what's to be learned, use it, and then maybe set a calendar to come back in a month and to do it again and see how things have changed, read through what you've just done today and kind of add to it. So this could be kind of a moving forward, a continuation. All right. Well, I hope this is interesting to you. You're having fun with it. Take care, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.